So what do I get as the first equation? So from the del SR by del A naught equal to 0, this is what I get. I'll get minus 2 summation I is equal to 1 to n y sub I, then plus 2 A naught summation 1 I is equal to 1 to n, then plus 2 A1 summation I is equal to 1 to n x of I, and the last one which I'll get is 2 A2 summation I is equal to 1 to n x I square equal to 0. That's what I'm going to get from the first summation which I have. Now you'll have to refer to what I've done earlier to be able to look at that. So this one is implying this, and this one implies what? This one implies minus 2 summation I is equal to 1 to n, and I will get x of I, y sub I, plus 2 a naught summation I is equal to 1 to n x of I, plus 2 summation a1 summation I is equal to 1 to n x I square, and plus 2a2 summation I is equal to 1 to n xi cube equal to 0. So that's what I'm going to get from the second equation. And the third equation, which was del SR by del a2 equal to 0, that'll give me minus 2 summation I is equal to 1 to n xi square y sub I plus 2a0 summation I is equal to 1 to n xi square, and then the next number will be 2 a sub 1 summation I is equal to 1 to n xi cube, and the last term in this last equation will be 2 times a2 summation I is equal to 1 to n xi raised to 4, and that will be equal to 0. So what you're basically getting is you're getting three equations. You're getting one equation right here. Okay, that's your first equation right there. Then this is your second equation, and this is your third equation which you're getting here. So you've got to set up these three equations. Now, if you look at these three equations which I have here, you've got to understand that when I'm going to set up these equations, what can I take to the right-hand side? I'll be able to take this to take this to the right-hand side. The reason why I'm able to take this to the right-hand side is because that's the known quantity. So I want to take all the right-hand sides all the knowns to the right-hand side. And then also, for example, this will be nothing but n, because there's summation of 1 going from 1 to n, so I'm adding 1 n times, so I'm going to get n from there. And all of these will stay on the left-hand side because I have a0, a1, and a2 as the unknowns. Now, if I look at a second equation, again, this quantity right here will go to the right-hand side. This quantity will go to the right-hand side because this is a known quantity. All the x's and y's are known. Again, these quantities will stay on the left-hand side because I have a0, a1, a2 as my unknowns. Same thing here. When I look at this quantity here will go to the right-hand side because xi and y sub i's are known to me. And that will go to the right-hand side, and I'll have these stay on the left-hand side because I have a0, a1, and a2. Now, before I do that, I'll go back to equation number 1 here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of this 2. And the reason I'm able to get rid of this 2 is because I can divide both sides by 2 because the right-hand side is 0. Same thing here. I can get rid of this 2 because the right-hand side is 0. I can get rid of this 2 because the right-hand side is 0. So that's how I'm able to simplify it a little bit. So if I now write down the equation, this is what I'm going to get. The first equation will turn out to be n times a naught plus a1 times summation x of I is equal to 1 to n, plus a2 summation I is equal to 1 to n x of I square is equal to summation x of I y sub I, because I took that to the right-hand side because the quantity is known. Now, the second equation which I'm going to get will be something like this. It will be a0 summation x of I is equal to 1 to n, and a1 summation I is equal to 1 to n x of I square, then the third quantity will be I is equal to 1 to n x I cube, and the right hand side, which I told you that I took the known to the right hand side, that would turn out to be something like this. This is just y sub I. Okay, so this is nothing but y sub I, and this one will be x of I times y sub I. That's from the second equation which I get. Now here, the equation number 3 will be a naught summation I is equal to 1 to n xi square. So that's what I get as the coefficient of a naught. The coefficient of a1 will turn out to be summation I is equal to 1 to n xi cube plus a, this should be a sub 2. And then a sub 2, summation I is equal to 1 to n xi 4, xi raised power 4, summation I is equal to 1 to n xi square y sub I. So I've rewritten my three equations and three unknowns now. My three unknowns being a naught, a1, and a2, and they are just simply being multiplied by certain summations. And I took the known quantities to the right-hand side, like this one I took to the right-hand side, this one I took to the right-hand side, and this one here I took to the right-hand side. So this sets up three equations, three unknowns. The good news is that these three equations, three unknowns are simultaneous linear equations. So since they are simultaneous linear equations, I don't need to worry about having to solve simultaneous nonlinear equations like I have to for other nonlinear regression models, such as power model or exponential model. So the good news here is that I'm just going to set up these simultaneous equations, but they are all linear in nature. So let me write down these equations in the matrix form, and that will form the basis for this. So the matrix form of these equations, which I just developed, will give a clear picture of how we're going to set up these coefficient matrix on the right-hand side so that we know what the unknowns are. So we've got a naught, a1, and a2 as the unknown, and the coefficients are n, summation x of I, and then summation x of I square. Then we have summation I is equal to 1 to n x of I, then summation I is equal to 1 to n x of I square here, and then summation I is equal to 1 to n xi cube here. And then same thing here, I have summation x of I square here, summation x of I cube here, and then summation I is equal to 1 to n xi to the power 4 here. So that's what I get in the coefficient matrix, and the right-hand side is nothing but summation of y sub I is equal to 1 to n, summation x of I, y sub I is equal to 1 to n, and summation I is equal to 1 to n, x of I square, y sub I. So you have all the known quantities on the right-hand side. The unknowns are a naught, a1, and a2, and then the coefficient matrix are also known quantities. And now we can use any kind of techniques which you have learned in your simultaneous linear equation method, such as Gauss elimination, Gauss Seidel, LU decomposition method, to calculate a naught, a1, and a2. Now keep in mind that what happens is that when you start doing polynomial regression like this, and let's suppose you're doing a higher order polynomial regression like this, fourth or fifth order polynomial, you can see that the order of the terms is going to be very different from one row to another. Like for example, here you just have the number of elements in here, and here you have xi raised power 4. So if xi values of the x values are very small, then xi raised power 4 will be even smaller. If xi is a large number, then xi raised power 4 will be very large numbers. So what happens is that whenever you're doing polynomial regression, it creeps in some ill conditioning in the system of equations. So you should be very careful when you are conducting polynomial regression, especially higher polynomial regression like fourth and fifth order polynomials, are you getting a coefficient matrix which is well conditioned or not. So you should be careful about that. So once you find a0, a1, and a2, then your regression model is nothing but a0, a1x, plus a2x squared. And that gives us the regression model. And that's what we were trying to find in the first place. And that's the end of this derivation.